I'm James Taylor. Welcome to my Maya 2016 female body modeling tutorial. I'll start with my image planes already in place, and I'll create a cylinder for the torso. And this will have 14 subdivisions on the axis and 4 on the height. And I'll rotate it ever so slightly just to center that main center line. I'll adjust it quickly to match my reference. Then I'll create a cylinder for the arm. This one is going to have 6 for both the subdivisions on the axis and the height. And I'll create the leg last. This one has 8 subdivisions on the axis and 6 for the height. And I'll position and scale all of these generally to match my reference. And then I'm going to go into vertex mode on my torso, and I'll start working with entire rows of verts. And I'll just match them up to my reference. And we're only going to be able to get close here. We're not going to be able to get perfect. So we're not trying to get a perfect match. We don't want to add any more subdivisions yet. So my rows will sit on the calves, on the rib cage, on the waist, on the hips, and then the bottom of the pelvis. And then I'm going to switch over to my side view, and I'll adjust entire rows again. This time I'm also rotating them slightly, and this will match the curvature of the spine just a little bit better. Then I'm going to create the neck by selecting the faces at the top of the body, and I'll extrude them out once. I'll pull that up and shrink it a little bit. This will be the base of the neck, and then I'll extrude one more time to create the neck itself. I'll spend a little bit of time adjusting the verts in this region just to create a little bit better anatomy. And then I'll repeat this same process on the arm. So I'll start on the arm in the front view. I'll use edge rings, and I'll just select entire rows of edges and reposition them in the front view to match my reference. You'll see I capture some of the shape of the hand. And then at the top of the arm where the shoulder goes, you'll see that I leave it kind of with a gap in there. And that's because I'm going to extrude the shoulder out from the torso. So I'll go to side view, and I'll rotate it to match my image reference here. And then I'll just use my scale tool to scale those rows out to add a little bit more volume. And because I've rotated the object and I'm using local transforms, that'll make the scaling process a lot easier. When I'm done, I'll just move it back and scale it back into its original position. And then I'll grab the verts on the forearm. I'll move the pivot by holding D, and then I'll just rotate it to give it a little bit of a natural curve. The last thing I'll do before moving on to the leg is just deleting those top cap faces. And then I'll do the same basic process with the leg. So I'm working on entire rows of either verts or edges. I'm going to position them in the front view first because my front view is my dominant reference. And I'll just match my shapes up as best as I can. At the bottom of the leg, I'll match that to the top of the ankle. And then I'll grab those faces and just extrude them down to create the rest of the ankle and the base of the foot. And then it's just a matter of matching up the rest of the leg. So with the top part of the leg, you'll see that I end the leg a little bit above the base of the torso. We're going to connect those later. Now I'll tackle the leg in the side view. And with the leg, we want to remember that it is not a straight line. The lower leg sits significantly behind the upper leg. If we don't get this right, our character will look perpetually off balance. For the knee, I'll angle it just a little bit downwards, and then that top row, I'll scale outwards to match the extents of the butt. And then like the arm, I'll delete that top cap. Now, I do want to work symmetrically, so I'll select the arm and the leg, and I'll move the pivot to the center of the body, and then I'll use Duplicate Special, and I want to go into the Options here. In the Options, I want to make sure that Instance is checked, and the X scale is set to -1, and then when I duplicate that, I'll get Mirror Image Versions. Now, with the arm, I will have to rotate that into place to make it look perfectly symmetrical, but now I'm going to have versions of arm and the leg that I can make changes to one half, and it will reflect on the opposite half. Now I'm going to work on connecting the arm and the body via the shoulder. So I'll turn on my Insert Edge Loop tool, and I'm going to add an edge ring right into the middle of the upper torso there, and then I'll expand that edge ring out in both the front and the side views. And while I'm inserting edges, I'll add one more edge ring into the abdomen and just add a little bit more shape there. And then I'll tweak the edges in the abdomen and the hip area just to match my front view reference a little bit more closely. in the shoulder region, I'll adjust these two edges and just pull them out so that they fit the arm a little bit better. But I'll see that I'm not working symmetrically here. So I could try and turn on my symmetry tools, but the easiest way to handle this is to just go to face mode, select half of the torso and delete it. And then on object mode, I'll just use my duplicate special trick again. Now, because we rotated it in the beginning, we're gonna wanna use modify freeze transformation before we do that duplicate special. Once we do that, it'll work all right. So now I can go back to adjusting those edges to create the correct volume at the top of the torso. I'll make a few more anatomy tweaks, and then I'm ready to start connecting things. So if we look at the topology in the shoulder area, we see that we have these two parallel rows of faces that go over the top, and then we have another ring of faces that encircles the shoulder, and it also connects to the row that underlies the breast. This will give us good deformation in the region. I'll select these two faces to start with, and I'll extrude them straight out over the arm. And then I'll grab the faces underneath that extrusion and just delete those. So this is going to be the cap for the shoulder, and I'll grab these verts and snap them to the verts at the top of the arm. Vertex snap, just hold down the V key. I'll make a few tweaks in the region based on my front view reference. I'll round out the shoulders from the side view a little bit. And then I want to go to object mode. I'll select both the arm and the body, and I'll use my combine to make them a single mesh. Once they're combined, I can duplicate special again, and I'll merge those verts in the shoulder region. Now I have to worry about the connection under the arm. So I'll pull those verts down just to make a little bit of room and make it easier for me to work with. And I'll select these two edges between the body and the arm and use my bridge tool. I want to set the divisions on the bridge tool to zero. And then I'll do the same thing on the back. So I've connected under the arm, and now I'm left with this triangular shape to fill in. And that can be resolved quickly by just grabbing these edges that go up and around the top of the arm and using connect components. That'll leave me with open verts on those triangles that I can just merge together with the verts on the arm in that same area. I'll make a few tweaks to the resulting shape using my front view reference, and then I want to switch to smooth proxy mode, so I'll just hit 3 on my keyboard. I'll delete the cap faces at the bottom of the torso and at the top of the neck, and we'll see that once I smooth my mesh, it's going to change the volume of the character very significantly. So I'll have to go through and readjust my mesh to match my reference again. And since we're working smoothed from now on, we don't really care what it's going to look like in unsmoothed mode, so don't worry about that. And I want to remember to make the same changes in the side view. We want to double check all of our reference to make sure that we haven't lost volume in key areas. While I'm doing this, I'll use this as a chance to fix some of the anatomy and other areas on the character. So I've narrowed the clavicles, and I'm going to add another set of subdivisions right in the middle of the neck using my insert edge loop tool, just so I can create a little bit more of an elegant curve to the neck. And with the neck, we want to remember that it's lower in the front than it is on the back. And I'll pull those clavicles up against that lowered neck. That'll start to create that natural clavicle shape. And then I can move on to connecting the leg and the body. So with the butt on the back, we see that it's mostly a grid of faces, but there's also this row that curves up and around. And then if we look on the front, we've got this diagonal structure in the pelvis. Both of these are going to be important for getting proper deformation. I'll start off by grabbing these two edges on the bottom of the torso and bridging them together. And then I'll select the two edges on that resulting bridge, and I'll connect them to create an extra subdivision, and I'll do that a couple more times. Then I'll move these new edges down and around to create kind of a ring at the bottom of the body. With those new edges, I'll also grab the verts and adjust them based on my reference. So on the front of the body, this ring is going to be much wider. That'll create the shape of the pelvis there. And then on the back, it's going to be much narrower. This is going to be the start of the shape for the butt. Now we're at the point where I want to combine the leg to the rest of the body. So I'll just select them and do a mesh combine. I'll adjust my pivot point, and I'll duplicate special again. And then I'll pull that top row on the leg down a little bit to make a little bit of space. And we should see some agreement between the body and the leg here. I want to position my verts to make sure that I get that kind of straight line matchup. And then I can adjust some of the points on the back of the torso. I just want to create a little bit of roundness looking at it from above to help define the shape of the butt. I'll select the top two backmost edges on the leg and I'll pull them down. That's going to create the space that we need to fit the butt in. On the front of the pelvis, I'll grab this edge and pull it down, and then I'll connect above that to add another row right above it. I'll add a little bit of roundness in this area, and then I'll make a few more tweaks, mostly from the side view, to kind of open up this whole region. So I'm creating more of a circular opening around the side of the torso, and now I'm set to start connecting the leg and body. I'll begin by selecting these two edges and bridging them together, and then I'll grab these two verts here, and I'll merge them to center. I'll adjust the verts in this area to kind of smooth things out, and then I'll look under the body and I'll grab these two verts and merge those together as well. And now that area is well defined with quads, so I can start to fill in the rest of the connections. And I'll grab these two edges and bridge, and then the next two set of edges and bridge those as well. And then I can tweak the anatomy in this area, but I run into an issue that I'm going to need to use my crease tool to fix. So the crease tool, I can select verts or edges and then middle mouse drag to crease those. And then what that does is it makes those areas hold their shape better when we have the smooth proxy turned on. Here I'm using it to create more of a corner between the leg and the pelvis so that I get more of a sharp transition there. Feels a little bit more natural. I'll spin around to the back here and I'll grab these two sets of edges, the two on the top and the two on the bottom of the butt, and bridge those together. And then I'll add a division to that either via the bridge tool or using connect components or something like that. And now I can pull that set of edges out, create a little bit more of the curvature of the butt in that area. I'll start closing up the hole on the inside of the butt by grabbing these two verts here and just collapsing those, merging those verts to the center. That'll leave me with a triangle on the inside. What I'll do is I'll grab these three edges and use connect components to add another set of subdivisions there. And then I can just select these two edges and bridge across, and that will fill up that area with a quad and we're all set. For this outside hole, I'm going to select that bottom edge and use extrude edge and just pull that out a little bit. And I'll merge these bottom two verts together. And then I'll grab these two verts and merge those together. Now we're creating that kind of right angle corner that we need to create the proper topology on the outside of the butt. What we're left with is a simple quad that we can just either fill hole or bridge to fix. And now the topology on the butt is good and we can focus on anatomy. So I'm going to switch over to the neck now, and we can see that these faces on the shoulder go straight up and over, but then we've got these diagonal rows in the chest area, and I want to restructure this so that I get rid of those diagonals and I have straighter topology. So I'll adjust the anatomy very slightly, and then I'll select this ring of faces that goes around the neck, and it's basically the transition between the neck and the body. Once those are deleted, I'm going to go to edge mode, and I'm going to delete some of the edges on the neck because I don't need all those rows. Control delete is the shortcut that we want to use here. And basically I'll remove every other edge row, so I'm cutting the number of faces in the neck by half. Now I'll pull the clavicle on the body down and I'll flatten it out a little bit. And then I'll start bridging by grabbing these two edges on the front of the neck and then the next two in line. And then I'll just go around. And I'll see that I get nice quads pretty much everywhere, except for that triangle on the back there. Fortunately, getting rid of that is going to be pretty easy. I'll just select these two edges on the back and collapse them together. And so we'll lose a little bit of geometric detail in that region. Fortunately, that part of the body doesn't require it. So at this point, I'm going to add the breast, and the breast will be a polysphere that I will rotate so that the cap is facing us. I'll place it just generally in the location, and I'm going to reduce the number of subdivisions to try and match the topology in the body pretty generally in that region. So it should be pretty low res. I'll rotate it out slightly, and then I want to reshape it. So I'll grab the edge at the top and I'll pull it up, and it's best to do this in smooth mode. I'll just delete the back half because we're not going to need it. And that top row will come all the way up to the clavicle. And then you'll see that I adjust the verts on the bottom of the breast. I want to add a sense of weight here, and that's really important to capturing a natural shape. Once I'm happy with the shape overall, I want to turn on my multi-cut tool and use it to cut a corresponding hole on the body. So I'll just cut around on the torso, generally matching the shape of the breast as it sits on the chest. I'll delete the faces on the interior of that perimeter that I've just cut out. I'll add a couple more points on the outside edges here, and then I can worry about connecting the breast and the body together. So I'll grab the torso and the breast, and I'll combine those two objects together. And then I want to start merging vertices, and I want to merge from the torso to the breast. I don't want to move the shape of the breast a whole lot because I want to keep that natural smooth shape that we've created. In some cases, I will need to change the shape of the breast to match the body a little bit better. What I'll do in this case is I'll cut in new edges using my multi-cut or my insert edge loop tool so that those new edges sit on the body, and then I'll match the body to those new points. But I'm not going to move the shape of the breast if I can help it. Once things are merged together and smooth, we can evaluate the shape, and we'll see that we get this weird shadow up right near the arm. So we need to adjust our topology here. I'm going to use my multi-cut and cut another row under the breast, starting at the arm area. And I'll delete the existing edge from under the breast that I just cut around. That'll help smooth some of that area. And then I can take these new verts and just spread them out a little bit. And that will smooth some of that region. It'll get rid of some of the shadow. To address the shadow up near the shoulder, I'm going to grab this edge here and use my flip spin edge tool and just flip it so that it changes directions. I'll do the same thing on that edge there. And now we're getting a more natural transition. Feels like the pectoral is in there tying into the shoulder, and now the breast ties into the chest a lot better. Since it's hard to get at the underarm area to make some fixes, I'm going to grab my arm and just rotate it out slightly so that I have better access under the arm. And now I want to adjust the anatomy in this entire region. So you'll see I spin my camera around a lot. I'm looking at the breast from every angle to make sure that the shape is correct, and I'm making changes. Once I'm done, I'll just move the arm back into the arms down position for the next step. So I want to add my hands and feet, and I've imported existing hands and feet. They're the same hands and feet I created for the bodybuilder model, and I'm making edits to them so that they better fit my character. So I'm adjusting the volume and just fitting it to the reference. So when we're building our characters, we're generally not starting over every time we make a new character. We want to reuse assets whenever we can get away with it. Because the topology is very similar between these two models, they blend together nicely. And with that, our topology is done, and I can start to worry about anatomy. So in this case, I'm comparing the model that we've just completed, the gray one, with the finished, tweaked, anatomy polished version, which is in pink. We can see that there are a lot of differences that have a big overall impact on our viewer. So, for example, the neck and the clavicle region are a lot more defined. The breasts and the deltoids have a much more natural shape. The back and the butt are shaped a little bit more correctly, and we have much sharper definition in the abdomen, hip, and pelvis region. And this is the level of polish that we expect to see on a professional level model. So my extended cut tutorial goes a lot more in depth into creating these anatomy tweaks. It's three times as long as this one. I also spend a lot more time elaborating on creating proper topology for the model. Similarly, you can go to my site to download the actual model or the image plane references I used. And that's it for the body. Up next will be the head modeling video.